Hey there, how are you? This is Kali from TechFanciers. Straight to the point, I have been using this Havoc OS for quite some time now. We will be taking a look at latest official Havoc OS 3.6 GSI on an in-depth look, episode number 27. Official Havoc OS version 3.6 with the latest security patch of June 5th, 2020. Earlier, we made a video on Havoc OS 2.6, which is Android Pie with some Oxygen OS integration features. This version is also the same like earlier, but has some add-on features. In previous episode, we were talking look at Desert in the row. This OS is also one of the stable and usable Android 10 GSI. You have the same decent battery backup, I would say better than Android 10 beta. Camera, Wi-Fi, hotspot, Bluetooth and things are working fine. After the OLTI patch, the OLTI also worked. I didn't face any call issue or audio problem. Yes, still a low audio issue is there. I will definitely find a workaround. As of now, Dolby and Viper for Android makes it decent. The good thing which I missed in Desert is the network monitor indicator which we have here. Also here they have switched from launcher to shady launcher, which is fine, but the search bar is rounded square, not the normal one, so I turned it off. There are no or any dedicated app for music and all as we were having in Desert. You have to install everything. Only after installing the file manager you are able to set the ringtone. That's the point to note. We have 3x3 to 6x6 patterns, which is cool. Absolutely. We have face unlock. Unlike others, it is usable. Even it can be used to unlock some banking apps. I used the hotspot for some time. It worked fine. But sometimes even after turning the thing off, it just showing the network in other devices. That's weird. The performance and app switching is well improved compared to earlier Android 10 and Android 9 builds. I'm using Camera Go. You can use Google Camera after enabling Camera to API. I didn't install Magisk as of now. Along with all this, you have gaming mode, which I'm currently checking. As of now, it is an option to block the notification to improve the gaming experience. We'll definitely check on that. Is it actually usable or not? Well, that is it. The demerits which I noticed is while unlocking, sometimes the wallpaper is not coming from full screen. It is showing from quarter of the screen, which is delaying the unlocking. And I tried to install GPay, which was working in Desert, but it is not working here. I mean, it is not about security or Google Pass problem. It is not even showing the OTP screen. I installed the PhonePay, which is working fine. Also, after the first boot, the navbar is not enabled by default, so you need to go to the configuration center and install the navbar manually. I just enabled volume key to turn on the screen. To turn off the screen, I just enabled the double click to turn off the screen. I would suggest you guys to try this if you aren't using Resident OS. Also, I have asked you guys about the checklist which and all need to consider while reviewing or taking a look in the ROMs or builds. If you haven't updated it, kindly go to the community tab and update their equipment. This will help us a lot to improve the channel's delivery method. So that's what about this video. Leave a like if you enjoyed it and subscribe to this channel to support and encourage this work. If you have any queries and concerns, feel free to follow us and DM me at TechFanciers Insta page. Thank you for watching. Code Moto.